Good. Good afternoon, everyone. This is John Glover on this day of March 16th, 2017. We're here continuing the broadcast from last week. Just wanted to share with everyone the God order and news, which is God has ordained a black man, Professor G. Oyibo, with the ultimate intelligence of Eta sub infinity. Eta sub N exactly represents intelligence and N the level of intelligence. God has designed that N for Professor Oyibo to be infinity, hence Eta sub infinity. Since black people share the same genes as Professor G. Oyibo, God has reordained the black race not just the most intelligent race, but the richest or most powerful race. God Almighty's Grand Unified Theorem, nicknamed GAGUT, it's a revelation from God, which infallibly proved that all theorems and all equations, also called everything that exists, and also known as morphisms, which can be isomorphisms or polymorphisms, past, present, and future, all originate out of one invariant, GI, defined as God, with orthogonal components, GIJ, and a divergence of GIJ, J equals zero. Divergence is also known as change. Now, in mathematics, we can just use any term to define a quantity. Just because we state that GI defines God doesn't automatically prove that it is God. As an example I've given several times before, it's like, if you, one can say that milk originates out of the store. If the store happens to be the ultimate origin point of the milk, you then can replace the term originates out of with created by in that instance. But as we all know, milk doesn't originate out of the store, it originates out of the cows. So in that case, we cannot use the term originates out of for the store, nor can we replace the term originates out of with its equivalent created by. However, GAGUT infallibly proved that GI is the ultimate origin of all theorems, also called everything that exists. So the phrase originates out of can be replaced with the creation created by, which proves that GI defined here defines God and represents God, since God can be defined as the creator of everything. Now that God has been infallibly defined as GIJ, God's existence is the next step of the verification. And God's existence is infallibly proven if GAGUT can prove that something exists, which is easily done by showing that a human being exists, like yourselves and myself. The existence of a human being is the proof of the existence of God, and GIJ, because GIJ has been infallibly proven to be the ultimate origin of everything that exists. Therefore, because a human being exists, it infallibly proves the existence of the GIJ, and which also previously has been infallibly defined and proven to be God. That's important to understand because the existence of a human being ultimately infallibly proves the existence of God. Now, I mentioned the term morphisms earlier. In terms of morphisms, which can be isomorphisms or polymorphisms, they're also known in mathematics as equations. And these equations, they map realities onto a mathematical space, similar to how our senses, our ears, our eyes, our hands to touch, and other things, even sometimes taste, all our senses allow us to map reality onto our brains in terms of what we determine from our senses around us, we're able to map onto our brain. Those are what we call polymorphisms that are in effect. The polymorphisms are a measure of intelligence. Since GIJ, which infallibly defines God, has the totality of all equations, GIJ and hence God constitutes the totality of all intelligence. The GAGUT solution, Eta sub N, which all come out of GIJ or God, fundamentally represents all isomorphisms as well as all polymorphisms, and therefore contains all of intelligence. It has also infallibly proved that God not only contains all of intelligence, but also God is all of intelligence. God amazingly all Eta sub N's in the brains of Professor Oyibo, which is in fact all of intelligence inside Professor Oyibo, and blessed him with the ultimate or the total reality of all intelligence, which was to understand everything, including God. This is how God has ordained Professor Oyibo with the totality of all intelligence, or what we call here in the OFAPIC Institute of Technology, the ultimate intelligence, which can modestly be stated as God has ordained Professor Oyibo with the ultimate intelligence, or the being the greatest genius and the most intelligent human being ever created. Since the black race share the same genes as Professor Oyibo, God has reordained the black race as the most intelligent race. And this has been confirmed by Jim Crow through various organizations and universities around the world. One of the first which I'll bring to your attention is a German university based, a German university known as Göttingen University. I'm going to be sharing it with you all so that you can see that particular piece. Just bear in mind. Do you all see the piece in front of you, the Göttingen Gauss 2005 celebration?
Yes, yes.
Praise God. Do you see that as well, Mr. Cruz?
Mr. Cruz,
do you see it? Mr. Cruz, do you see the page in front of you? Is he still on, Mr. Cruz? Mr. Zagar, can you hear me?
I hear you. Yep.
Okay, is Mr. Cruz still there? Can you try to see if he's...
Mr. Cruz, you there? Mr. Cruz, I guess it must be his battery.
Okay, but he's still on. That's why I'm surprised. Mr. Cruz, can you hear us? Can you respond, please?
Yes, I can see.
Thank you. I just want to make sure that we're all on the same page. That's why I asked if you can see. It's important that I hear feedback so we know if you understand it. If you don't, we can then help you or explain that point. But it's good that you're now seeing it. What you're seeing here is the surrender from Göttingen University, in which Göttingen University selected the greatest mathematics works to honor the greatest mathematician since antiquity before GAGUT, which was Professor Carl Friedrich Gauss, who headed the mathematics department at Göttingen University. Gauss lived from 1777 to 1855. And in the year 2005, 150 years after the transforming of Gauss, Göttingen University celebrated Gauss by selecting for each week of the year, 52 weeks in total, the greatest mathematics works to honor Professor Carl Friedrich Gauss. As you can see at the top of the list, they selected the work by Professor Oyibo, Professor Gabriel A. Oyibo, in terms of the GAGUT work, Grand Unified Theorem, as the number one work to honor Gauss in the center of that celebration. To understand its ranking, however, you have to understand the runners-up in terms of who could have been in that selection. I'm sorry. Okay. If you go to NR 19 or week 19, you'll see the name Sir Professor Michael Attia and Daniel Iagonitzer, and the work is titled Field Medalist Lectures. Sir Professor Michael Attia, so if you can see here, does everyone see Sir Professor Michael Attia's page on Wikipedia in front of them?
Yeah.
Okay. Sir Professor Michael Attia is a current day English mathematician who once held the position at Cambridge University of the Master of Trinity College in Cambridge from 1990 to 1997, as you can see highlighted in the blue. Can everyone see that?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Sir Professor Michael Attia is a successor to Sir Professor Isaac Newton, also from Cambridge. Newton's held that same chair in terms of the Master of Trinity College. So Attia is a successor to Newton in that essence. And Newton is considered, along with Gauss and Euler, another mathematician, as the top three European mathematicians in the European society. So why that's particularly important is Attia is a successor to Newton. Attia has also won an award, which is also important, which is the Field Medal. The work that you saw week 19 was titled Field Medalist, as in plural, meaning more than one Field Medalist winners. The Field Medal, as you can see here, described in this second to last line in the first paragraph, Field Medal, ignore the Abel Prize for the moment, but the Field Medal, it has often been described as the mathematician's Nobel Prize. It's an award equivalent to Nobel Prize. So an award was created in 1936, and as you can see, the medal was first awarded in 1936, and it's been awarded every four or so years, and two, three, or four mathematicians worldwide every 4 years wins it. So what's important to understand in light of that is that, as it says here, the Field Medal has often been described as the Nobel Prize of Mathematics, and for a long time was regarded as the most prestigious award in the field of mathematics. You can see that. Does everyone see that highlighted in the blue? Okay, yep. Great God. So then if you go below, you'll see the list of the people who have won the award over the last couple of years. See the names. You can see Atiyah's name being circled here, or I should highlight, for 1966. Can everyone see Atiyah highlighted in the blue?
Yeah.
Okay. That's where he was placed in terms of one of the Field Medalist winners. If you keep scrolling down, you see throughout the other years how many people have been winners of that award. Okay, so up until about 2002, which last year before the 2005 celebration at Gauss, there are about 44 Nobel Prize award equivalents, including Atiyah. And as it said, the Field Medal is equivalent to Nobel Prize. So any one of these things could have placed Atiyah's work as the number one work to honor Gauss because, one, he's a successor to Sir Professor Isaac Newton, and both held the Master of Trinity College title, the prestigious mathematics chair at Cambridge University. Atiyah is a Field Medalist. He has won an award which is equivalent to Nobel Prize. And the work Field Medalist Lectures contains all the Field Medalist works from 1936 up until that year, 2005, which including Atiyah would be about 44 of them. Any one of those points could have made that work the number one work to honor Professor Carl Friedrich Gauss. Göttingen, however, ranked that work inferior to GAGUT. That is why it's placed at week 19, 7 places below where GAGUT was placed at week 26. In addition, when they've done that, Göttingen has declared GAGUT as being worth more than 44 Field Medals or Nobel Prizes. Can you all see that?
Yes.
Mr. Uzugar? Mr. Uzugar?
Yes.
Okay, praise God for that. It's good that everyone's on the same page here. So let's go to number 23. We see the name Alexei Viktorovich Bozhinov and Anatoly Tifremenko. Yes. Now, the second name is the most important in terms of Anatoly Tifremenko. Who is he, you ask? Anatoly Tifremenko is a current-day Russian mathematician, born in 1945, who is a Russian mathematician. He's a part of the Moscow State and the Russian Academy of Sciences, which is a combined university system in Russia. What's important to understand is that Tifremenko is a successor to another famous European mathematician by the name of Leonard Euler. Can everyone see Leonard Euler up on their screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Euler, born in 1707 but dying in 1783, is he was a German-Swiss mathematician who spent most of his adult life in the Russian university system. Euler, like Newton and Gauss, is considered to be the top three European mathematicians. But as you can see here in the bottom of last line of the second paragraph, he spent most of his adult life in St. Petersburg, Russia. Does everyone see that highlighted in the blue?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So he also was in the Russian university system where he spent most of his adult life doing his mathematical research. It's important to understand that Tifremenko is a successor to Euler in that regard. That could have placed Tifremenko's work as the number one work to honor Gauss because Gauss had a lot of respect for Euler. However, Göttingen ranked that work inferior to GAGUT, which is why Tifremenko's work is placed at week 23, 3 places below GAGUT, which was placed at week 26. Can you all see that?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. And then we go to week 24, where you'll see the name Professor David Hilbert, Knowledge of Mathematical Thinking. Now, if you see that Professor Hilbert, can everyone see Professor Hilbert's page in front of them?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Professor Hilbert, born in 1862, dying in 1943, or passing or transforming on in 1943, is a German mathematician who actually comes from Göttingen University. He was a successor to Carl Friedrich Gauss as the head of the mathematics department at Göttingen University. He's also widely regarded as one of the most influential and universal mathematicians in the 19th and early 20th centuries, and considered to be the last of the great mathematicians. What's also important to understand is, as you can see here on the right side of the page, you'll see one of the institutions he's associated with is GAGUT and highlighted in the blue. Do you all see that?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. He is also known for overseeing 69 PhDs in mathematics. If you look under the same column with the doctoral students, you'll see the list of the people, that, not only the list of the people, but they have links, to separate links that shows each one of them in terms of what happened in terms of their careers. Most of the time, mathematicians are lucky to get a couple, maybe one, two, or three students that get PhDs under them and become stars in their own right. Hilbert oversaw 69 PhDs in mathematics, and almost all of them became stars in their own rights. You can see the list of the names of those people to the right. Can you all see that?
Yes.
Okay. So he oversaw 69 PhDs in mathematics. So any one of those things could have made Hilbert's work the number one work to honor Gauss. First of all, he's considered to be the last of the mathematicians, the successor to Gauss at Göttingen in terms of heading the mathematics department sometime after Gauss. And he's also overseen, he's considered the last of the great mathematicians and overseen 69 PhDs in mathematics. Göttingen, despite knowing this about Hilbert, painfully ranked Hilbert's work inferior to GAGUT. That's why Hilbert's work is placed two places below GAGUT. So why is GAGUT's place as the number one work so important? Why is that critical? The thing that needs to be digested here is the GAGUT work was considered to be the number one work to honor Professor Carl Friedrich Gauss because GAGUT, God Almighty's Grand Unified Theorem, decoded that mathematics is the study of theorems. Theorems, despite the fancy terminology, it basically, as I said before, represents anything that exists or reality. 2 + 1 = 3 is a theorem because it is not only a reality, it's something that you can prove to be true infallibly. You take two fingers in one hand, take one finger in the other. The operation of addition says you count those together. You add the 2 and the 1 together, you get 3. 3 on the left-hand side of the equal sign will be equal to 3 on the other side of that equal sign. You have a theorem. That's what mathematics is, the study of theorems. GAGUT has also decoded that from the definition of GAGUT, God Almighty's Grand Unified Theorem. All words that make up that acronym are important, but the last two words are the most important, which is unified and theorem. When you take those words just by themselves, unified theorem, it means it contains all theorems. Does everyone see that?
Yes.
Yep.
So if GAGUT has now determined that mathematics is the study of theorems, and that GAGUT itself contains all theorems from its own definition, one can now infallibly prove and deduce that GAGUT contains all of mathematics. Do you all see that?
Yep.
Yes,
what
sir.
This means, and this is what the Germans saw once they realized GAGUT contains all of mathematics, it can reproduce the work of Sir Professor Michael Atiyah at week 19, along with the other field medalists. It can also reproduce the work of Anatoly Flamenko at week 23. It can reproduce the work of Professor David Hilbert at week 24. It can also reproduce the works of Professor Newton, Sir Professor Isaac Newton. It can also reproduce the work of Leonard Euler. You can also reproduce the work of Professor Bernard Riemann and Professor Carl Friedrich Gauss, to whom the celebration was dedicated towards. That's why it was called the Gauss Year 2005. What they recognized by GAGUT, which since it has contains all mathematics, it can reproduce every one of the mathematics works that are on that list that are correct and not on that list, which are correct. So knowing that GAGUT contains all mathematics and can reproduce any mathematical work, it forced the Germans now to recognize GAGUT not just as number one work, but they have now taken the baton from Gauss, who before GAGUT, they declared Gauss the greatest mathematician since antiquity, or the greatest mathematician. Now, in light of GAGUT, they have now declared Professor Oyibo as being the greatest mathematician of all time that can never be surpassed, past, present, and future. This is a very important distinction to understand because when you talk about GAGUT, GAGUT has now forced the Germans, who before GAGUT, they would have never put a black person on this list. Because of the way Jim Crow structured, black people are automatically kept out of the field of mathematics. And even if you do get in, you would never make this list honoring Gauss. GAGUT now has forced them not only to put a black person on that list, but at the very top, because GAGUT contains all mathematics works. That means, like I said before, they've taken the baton from Gauss and handed it over to Professor Oyibo and declared Professor Oyibo as being the greatest mathematician of all time that can never be surpassed, past, present, and future, infallibly. So what's important to understand in light of that is that Göttingen has in effect surrendered, because black people who share Professor Oyibo's genes, when they've declared Professor Oyibo as being the greatest mathematician of all time that can never be surpassed, past, present, and future, and GAGUT was the basis for that, since black people share the same genes as Professor Oyibo, God has now reordained the black race as the most intelligent, richest, and most powerful race. And this is why Göttingen has surrendered, by showing this understanding of GAGUT as being the number one work to honor Professor Carl Friedrich Gauss. Do you all understand this?
Yes.
Yep.
That's a very important surrender, because the Germans, they were considered before GAGUT, the so-called head, this Göttingen in particular, as the headquarters of intelligence. GAGUT now has surrendered to the black people, who are now declaring Professor Oyibo as the greatest mathematician of all time that can never be surpassed, past, present, and future, infallibly. They have also surrendered that baton of excellence over to OFAPIT Institute of Technology as the true headquarters of intelligence, which you are part of today in learning from with this briefing. You understand that?
Praise God.
Praise God, yeah. Is right. Now, it didn't stop there. We also have, in India, another part that needs to be important. Everyone see the paper in front of them from India?
Yeah.
Yes. Now, this is a paper titled Gauge Conditions for an Abelian Chern-Simon System Consistent with Equations of Motion. Now, there are a lot of names there, but there's one particular name I'd like to look at, which is being circled. The name Krishendu Dasgupta. Can everyone see that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Professor Krishendu Dasgupta is a mathematical physicist who's part of the Department of Physics at Jamia Millia Islamia. Jamia Millia Islamia is a top 20 school in India. It was a school funded by the King of Saudi Arabia. What's important to understand is that Dasgupta comes from a group of people, Indians, who have won a great deal of Nobel Prizes looking for what we found as black people, which is the God Almighty's Grand Unified Theorem. They were looking for a unified field theory. Oh, sorry about that. Sorry about the decrease in size there for a second. But what's important to understand is that Dasgupta comes from a group of people who have won a great deal of Nobel Prizes in the search for it. You may have heard back in 1983, Indian professor by the name of Chandrasekhar winning a Nobel Prize for what's known as the Chandrasekhar limit, where a star reaches a certain mass before it implodes and becomes a black hole. You may have also heard about Abdul Salam, who, along with two European mathematicians, won a Nobel Prize in 1979 for the electromagnetic and weak force unification, two of the known forces in physics that were unified. But what's important to understand is the Indians have won a great deal of Nobel Prizes in this search, and they were one of the hopefuls in terms of coming up with this discovery of GAGUT. In addition to that, Dasgupta comes from a system like we see with Jim Crow, where they classify things based off of skin color. In terms of the so-called light-skinned Indians in India are considered the highest level in India. And as you get into darker shades of color, you get into lower levels in that same society. And when you get to the lowest level, where the black people are in India, they're referred to as Dalit or untouchable. This is part of what's known as the caste system in India. Dasgupta comes from that. What makes this even more interesting is that Dasgupta also comes from a group of people, Indians, who, because of the Jim Crow mentality of being able to tolerate Indian people better than they would black people, they've indoctrinated the Indian people as seeing themselves as being better than black people before GAGUT. You could have had $1 million as a black person, and you could pay that an Indian friend, or so-called, that amount of money, There's still no amount of money you could pay an Indian before GAGUT that would have them even admitting that you were on the same level, let alone superior to them. In addition to that, you also have to understand that Dasgupta comes from that background, and he failed in finding anything in terms of unified field theory, let alone GAGUT, what he searched for. When he had heard that Professor Oyibo had been blessed by God with the solution to GAGUT, in terms of G-I-J, comma J equals zero, he wrote, let me get this out, it's just some stupid error message. Sorry about that. Let me get this back. Just bear with me for a second. Ah, can you everyone see the page in front of them now?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay. He wrote an email to our university after hearing about GAGUT and Professor Oyibo being blessed by God with the solution. And the title of the email, as you can see, was dated Wednesday, July 25th, 2007, almost 10 years ago. And he wrote the email titled God's Mission and Dasgupta. It reads as follows. God's Mission and Dasgupta reads as follows. Dear Oyibo, good day. I've heard that you've been successful in finding the unified field theory. Congratulations. Now, this is the part I want everyone to listen to because this is the most important part of this message.
Yes.
You are more close to God than any of us. Was interfering with our thing again. Just bear in mind, I'm sorry about that, but let me. These pop-ups are coming out of everywhere. Just bear in mind, it's I'll get it back up. Don't worry about it.
No problem.
Just bear in mind, it's loading just at the moment. Okay. Let's scroll down so we can see the message again. You are more close to God than any of us. You are more close to God than any of us. I was also working upon this theory. Since my theory was different, God was different to me. Please write to me, as I would like to know where I was wrong. Thanking you, yours, Krishendu Dasgupta. Now, again, like I said before, Dasgupta comes from a system which would have viewed Professor Oyibo before GAGUT as a Dalit or untouchable, which is the so-called lowest level in their society. GAGUT forced an Indian who comes from a caste system like that and indoctrination from Jim Crow that Indians are so-called better than black people to now see a Dalit who he would have viewed before GAGUT as being a lower level or untouchable, now is seeing Professor Oyibo as closer to God than any of us, in effect stating a black man is superior to an Indian. That is what we call a diametrically opposed position to what was previously thought, which is what is the important part about GAGUT. GAGUT forced an Indian now to recognize a black man as being superior to them who comes from a caste system. And since Dasgupta represents Asia in general, he's now saying when he says Professor Oyibo is closer to God than any of us, since black people share the same genes as Professor Oyibo, that makes the black race closer to God than any other race. Do you all see that?
Yep.
You all see that?
Yes.
Yep.
I can't hear you.
Yes.
Yep.
Praise God. That's what's important to understand in terms of the surrender that has been demonstrated by God. Like I said, Dasgupta. Like I said also before, there's no amount of money a black person could have prior to the GAGUT discovery that you could pay an Indian to get them to even admit that you're even close to them, let alone superior to them. GAGUT, however, forced them to recognize the truth about the black people. that the black people, because Professor Oyibo is closer to God than any of us, the black people who share his genes are closer to God than any other race. You understand that?
Yep.
Now, also, like I said before, that sculptor comes from a university called Jamia Millia Islamia, a top 20 school in India, but also a school funded by the King of Saudi Arabia. Now, in the part of the world where that sculptor comes from, a couple of years earlier, some decades before, in the year 1988, a man by the name of Salman Rushdie, another Indian, actually wrote something which angered the Islamic community so badly that it actually forced... It forced them to actually put the Ayatollah of Iran, who was at the time in 1988, it forced them to put what they call a fatwa on Rushdie's head. He wrote a book called Satanic Verses. And it angered the Islamic community so badly, it forced the Islamic community through the Ayatollah of Iran to actually put a fatwa on Salman Rushdie. A fatwa loosely translated is assassination or death sentence put on Rushdie for what he has said in that book. And why that's critical to understand is that this is the background that sculptor comes from. Even though it's from India, it's from an Islamic part of India where if he had said something that the Islamic community had a problem with or had an issue that they could take with it, they could have put a fatwa on Dasgupta for articulating what he said. But because Professor Dasgupta declared the truth in declaring Professor Oyibo as being closer to God than any of us, that's why no fatwa was put on his head. And that's why even in this year, 2017, his life is still protected. It's almost 10 years later. You all understand?
Yes.
That's important. And like I said, that sculptor represents Asia. So there's almost over a billion Indians. And their neighbors, China, also celebrated the GAGUT discovery when they actually issued and aired in their People's Daily, the fifth largest newspaper in the world. They actually aired proudly that GAGUT, or Professor Oyibo, has now won the greatest academic prize in history due to GAGUT, which is the African International Prize for Science and Technology Award. This is the greatest academic prize, which was created by the Nigerian Senate, in terms of the GAGUT Nigerian Senate motion number 151. So what's important to understand is that they were, like I said, People's Daily is the fifth largest newspaper in the world. They openly celebrated the GAGUT discovery, winning this greatest academic award in their paper back in October of 2006. So these are the things you have to understand in terms of, like Africans showed a surrender for Europe, this is how Asia has shown their surrender through Dasgupta declaring Professor Oyibo as being closer to God than any of us. In addition, when Dasgupta made that statement, coming from an Islamic background, he could have declared Professor Oyibo as being close to Muhammad, because Muhammad, ironically, is even more prominent figure in Islam than Allah. So when he said that Professor Oyibo was closer to God than any of us, he didn't say Professor Oyibo is approaching Muhammad or close to Muhammad or a prophet like Muhammad. When he said that Professor Oyibo is closer to God than any of us, he has in effect declared Professor Oyibo as superseding Muhammad, and more importantly, superseding that concept of Muhammad in Islam. Just as if he were Christian. In Christianity, the most prominent figure is not even God, but Jesus Christ. When Professor Oyibo when Professor Dasgupta declared Professor Oyibo as being closer to God than any of us, he didn't say Professor Oyibo is a Messiah like Jesus or approaching Jesus or being close to Jesus. When he said Professor Oyibo is closer to God than any of us, he has now officially declared Professor Oyibo as superseding Jesus Christ. Now, for many people, we say, oh, that's hyperbole. The brother's talking trash. Oh, he's just spouting out all kinds of irrelevant nonsense. The reason why this is an infallible proof that Professor Oyibo is closer to God than any of us is and supersedes both Jesus and Muhammad is due to the fact that Professor Oyibo has been blessed by God with the formula of G2j, J equals zero, which contains all theorems, all equations, and all realities. In addition, Professor Oyibo has been blessed with eta sub infinity intelligence. Neither Jesus nor Muhammad were blessed with such a formula. Only Professor Oyibo has, which is why it is an infallible proven truth that Professor Oyibo has been ordained closer to God than any of us, superseding Jesus and Muhammad. Do you both understand?
Yes.
Praise God for that. So what's important to understand in light of that is the next step, which is that Gupta, when he's made this statement, he has shown how Jim Crow is now forced to surrender, because India has been another extension of that Jim Crow mentality because of the way Jim Crow has conditioned most Indians to believe themselves as being better than black people before GAGUT. Now, as Dasgupta has declared Professor Oyibo as being closer to God than any of us, since black people share the same genes as Professor Joe Oyibo, that makes the black people now closer to God than any other race. That has destroyed and demolished the caste system. It is diametrically opposed and turned it on its head. Where before Dasgupta and before the statement by Dasgupta, Jim Crow and caste system were viewing black people at the bottom, GAGUT has now forced him to now look at black people at the very top. Can everyone see that?
Yes.
Yep.
So what do we say to that?
Praise God.
I didn't hear you.
Praise God.
I didn't hear both
Praise
of you.
God. Praise God.
Praise God. Praise God.
Amen. So that's the next surrender, like Gautigan. That's Gupta representing Asian surrender, but it didn't stop there. There's another surrender that took place in the country we live in right now, which is the U.S. This is represented by this particular paper. Can everyone see the GAGUT Yale study in front of them?
Yes.
Yep.
GAGUT has been around since 1990, and it's been around for 27 years. It officially came out in that year. But by 1997, during the Bill Clinton administration, they actually took the formula of A to sub N into the labs to determine the intelligence level of humans. They automatically recognized the formula coming out of GAGUT, A to sub N, as being the formula for intelligence, and that through that formula intelligence, that Professor Oyibo is blessed with A to sub infinity intelligence. So recognizing that, the next step was now to determine how do the black people's intelligence compare to non-blacks, which would be your whites, Asians, and Jews, and so forth. If you look in front of you, you see the paper that's titled Nuclear DNA Diversity and Worldwide Distributed Human Populations. If you look at the cursor, you see the year that it was published, which is 1997. Can you see that?
Yep.
Okay. And you can see the journal, Gene, an international journal on gene and genomes. The reason why this is important is if you look at the names below, you see the researchers who are part of this particular experiment. Now, if you look at the names, you can pretty much get a sense of who was conducting this experiment. But if it wasn't clear just by the names, one name in particular will tell you who was responsible for conducting this experiment. If you look here, you see the name Kenneth K. Kidd. Initially, everyone see that name being circled, first of all?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Kenneth K. Kidd, if you take the first, middle, and last initials, you get KKK. This should be obvious to any black person, the nature of who was conducting this experiment. In terms of this was not brothers or sisters doing this as a feel-good research. This was research conducted by Jim Crow. Can you all see that?
Yeah.
From the names that are listed there. So what's important to understand is, let's take a look at where Sir Kenneth King was coming from. If you look behind the name Kid, you'll see a superscript B. In the legend below, you'll see the superscript B corresponds to Yale University School of Medicine, Department of Genetics, 333 Cedar Street, New Haven, Connecticut, 06510. Professor Kenneth K. Kidd, who was the lead researcher of this experiment, was a professor of genetics from Yale University. You see that? You all see that?
Yep.
Does everyone see that?
Yeah.
Praise God. So, and if you look at the other universities that are involved in this, you'll see universities from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. That's not a black university there, you can see. Yale's not a black university. You have a university in Italy called La Sapienza. Institute is, well, I can't pronounce it, but it's in Italy. Obviously, that's not black. And even the other two universities in the United States, Pennsylvania State University and Louisiana State Universities, are not black universities. You can all see that.
Yep.
This was Jim Crow conducting this experiment. So it wasn't like black people just got together to do a field of research. This was done by Jim Crow using eta sub n in the experiments to determine the intelligence of black people and how their intelligence compared to non-blacks. If you look at the abstract of this paper, you will see in the fourth line. Can everyone see the fourth line where the mouse is being circled?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
In this way, the European bias and the nuclear dimorphism ascertainment has been avoided. What does that mean? Well, first of all, let's break it down. European bias is a synonym for what we all know as black people as Jim Crow. Everyone understand this?
Yeah.
Okay. So what they're saying is in this way, Jim Crow or European bias in the nuclear polymorphism, again, polymorphism is a measure of intelligence. The more polymorphisms an organism has, the more intelligent the organism is. Do you all understand that?
Yes.
Okay. So in a polymorphism ascertainment, they had to remove the European bias in order to obtain the correct results. In other words, they had to remove Jim Crow from the experiment to obtain the correct results. Once that Jim Crow factor was removed, what they were able to determine is the following. We now go to the sixth line. Can everyone see the sixth line of this particular research?
Yes.
It says 15 polymorphisms were shared among most of the populations compared, whereas 13 sites are found to be endemic to Africans and 4 to non-Africans. Let's break that statement down. When it says 15 polymorphisms were shared among most of the populations compared, what they're saying is amongst the human populations that they took, some consisted from Africa, from Europe, from Papua New Guinea, and Asia, and so forth, what they were determined is that the base number of polymorphisms that any human has is 15. There are 15 polymorphisms. It doesn't matter if you're an African or not African or black or non-black. You have a base constituent of 15 polymorphisms. You understand that?
Yes.
You both understand?
Yep.
Praise God.
Yep.
Now it says, whereas 13 sites are found to be endemic, that means there are 13 additional sites for Africans. So if you take the 15, which are common for all people, all humans, and you add 13 to that 15, 15 plus 13 is 28. Can you all see that?
Yes.
It also says there are 4 endemic to non-Africans. Again, non-Africans would be your whites, Asians, Jews, and so forth. 15 plus 4 is 19. Can you see that? So what this Yale study had, and the GAGUT Yale study has confirmed, is the black people's intelligence compared to the non-black people's intelligence, or African people's intelligence to non-African people's intelligence, is a ratio of 28 to 19. Can you all see that?
Yep.
Now, in addition to that, why that particular research is important is that 28 to 19 as a ratio can be rewritten as a fraction. Fraction basically being a number that has a numerator and a denominator. Numerator being the top number over the straight line, and the bottom number, which is known as a denominator, the number underneath it. So 28 to 19 can be rewritten as a fraction, which is 28 over 19. Now, 28 over 19, there's no common factor that can make that simpler. 28 and 19 don't share a common factor, so they can't be simplified. But then that goes into a concept you have to understand in terms of how Jim Crow conducts experiments and also how Jim Crow views black people in terms of whenever they admit things about black people. The number of polymorphisms is represented in GAGUT through the eta sub n formula. The eta sub n formula, the n part, which is the number or level of intelligence, that level of intelligence corresponds to the polymorphisms, which they're testing in this experiment or researching in this actual GAGUT Yale study. So when they declare black people as having an N or a polymorphism count of 28, that means we have an eta sub 28 for black people. But in reality, it's eta sub 28 plus. And I'm going to explain the plus in a second. For the non-blacks, when they declared them having 19 polymorphisms, the N level for them is 19. So that means that their formula is eta sub 19 minus. Do you see that?
Yep.
So why is it plus for the 28 for the black people and minus for the non-blacks in terms of the 19? Well, it comes down to the fact that when Jim Crow talks about black people or does anything in terms of analytical research or any research that's done on black people, they always like to underestimate black people in such research, or even when they conduct observations about black people. For example, the Million Man March, they talk about how there was so-called There's clearly over a million black people there. Jim Crow declares it as a couple of tens of thousands. That's part of the underestimation of black people by Jim Crow. So when they have admitted that black people have an N of 28 or a polymorphism count of 28, it is more likely more than that. And the other reason why we can prove it to be 28 plus is that Professor Oyibo has an N level or polymorphism count of infinity. So that means that Professor Oyibo has eta sub infinity intelligence. So if Professor Oyibo has eta sub infinity intelligence and Jim Crow declares that we have 28 as a level, there's the possibility of a black person having more than 28 but less than infinity. Can you see that?
Yes.
Yep.
So that's why it's 28 plus for black people. On the contrary, when it comes to Jim Crow always overestimates their own blessings. For example, when they declare themselves as having 19 or N a level of 19 or a polymorphism count of 19, it is more than likely less than that. So that's where the 19 minus comes when it comes to eta sub 19 minus intelligence for the non-blacks. And why this isn't critical is that understanding this basis of it's 28 plus for the black people and 19 minus for the non-blacks, now the fraction that we used or we came up with, which is 28 over 19, it can be simplified to make the point easier. We can now bring 28 up to say 30 because it's 28 plus, and we can bring the 19 down to 18. The reason being we're doing this approximation is so that you can see what this number really is in a simpler form. 28 over 19 can be now approximated to 30 over 18. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Yes.
Now, in the case of 30 over 18, now there's a common factor in both the numerator and the denominator of that fraction of 30 over 18, which is 6. 30 divided by 6 is 5, so the new numerator is 5 there. And 18 divided by 6 is 3. The new denominator is 3. So the fraction 30 over 18 can now be rewritten as 5 over 3. Can you see that? 5 over 3 is a reciprocal in mathematics, or an inversion of what Jim Crow had constantly tried to hammer onto the black people, which is 3/5. 3 over 5 is what Jim Crow declared black people as being. GAGUT has now decoded in reality black people are 5/3. In mathematics, when you have a numerator which is larger than your denominator, it is known as a improper fraction. An improper fraction is a fraction which is greater than 1. Since it's greater than 1, it can be rewritten as a mixed numeral, a number which is a combination of whole numbers and fractions. 5 over 3 can be rewritten as 1 2/3. Do you understand?
Yeah.
1 2/3 you can convert to a percentage. 1, when you convert to a percentage, is 100%. You understand that?
Yes.
1 2/3, when converted to percent, is approximately 167%. Do you see that?
Yeah.
So if Jim Crow are normal human beings, which are 100% human beings, what the GAGUT Yale studies confirmed infallibly is that black people are 167% approximately of a human being. And since that is over 100%, that makes black people superhumans. Do you understand?
Yes.
Yeah.
So what the Yale study has confirmed, like Gartigan did and like that sculptor did representing Asia, is that the black people are the most intelligent race. Professor Oyibo has eta sub infinity intelligence, but the black people have eta sub 28 plus intelligence compared to non-blacks who have eta sub 19 minus intelligence. So this is how Jim Crow surrendered here in America due to the intelligence of the black people. It is official. It's mathematical, it's scientific, and it's official. After 2,500 years of fraud from Jim Crow regarding the intelligence of the black people, GAGUT has now shown the reality of the black people's intelligence. And as this the basis today, we want to share with you this God order, which we want to internalize in every one of you so you can understand how your lives are supposed to be living. You're supposed to be living life as the most intelligent, richest, and most powerful race. Not people to be shot down in the streets. Not people to be treated like your so-called less, so-called second-class or third-class citizens, but as the most intelligent race. And this is what we want to get across to everyone today to understand this God order. You all understand?
Yes.
Yeah.
This is the God order that has been ordered for everyone to understand at this point. And we want to go over some more of the aspects that we were going over last time in further depth. Is that someone's phone?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Sorry.
So very shortly, we're going to be connecting Professor Yiborn. But I want these points understood about how GAGUT has now forced the world to recognize the reality of the black people. Without GAGUT, we would not have had to surrender from Gottigan. Gottigan's surrender only came about through GAGUT. Dasgupta would have never stated that Professor Yiborn was closer to God than any of us had there not been GAGUT. And the Yale study that you're seeing in front of you would have never concluded black people as the most intelligent race if there had not been GAGUT. So GAGUT is the basis of our power as a people. And today we're going to be going into depth about how GAGUT has given the black race our power back and our true position as who we are supposed to be in light of such a God order. This is what we've been ordered to hammer into your head. And hammer is not meant as a violent term, but to basically go over the necessity of propagandizing GAGUT, not in a bad sense, but in a truthful, godly sense. We here in the OFAPIT Institute of Technology deal with intelligence and reality. We don't deal with fraud. We don't deal with fraudulent propaganda like Jim Crow does. We deal with the substance of it, the reality of it. That is what we've been blessed with when we've been blessed with Eta sub infinity intelligence through Professor Yiborn. Professor Yiborn has been blessed with all intelligences, which to understand everything, which is God has permitted Professor Yiborn with such Eta sub infinity intelligence. And since we as black people, we share the same genes as Professor Gio Yiborn, that has now forced the world to now recognize the black race as the most intelligent race. It is this point that our people are not understanding, which is one of the reasons why we have to hammer this point into their heads to get them to understand, because once our people understand the reality of GAGUT, which is the only reality, the problems that we're facing or what we appear to be facing will be resolved. They've already been resolved through GAGUT, but because our people are not aware of GAGUT, it is similar to the Juneteenth celebration, which many of you may not know offhand, but I'll explain to you. Juneteenth celebration, for those who may have heard or know about it, deals with the issue of black people after the end of the American Civil War. The American Civil War took place from roughly 1861 to 1865. During the process of that war, there was what was called an Emancipation Proclamation in 1863, which was supposed to liberate black people from the plantations during that time period. By the war ending in 1865, black people were supposed to be freed everywhere in this country. However, a year after that war had been over, in 1866, it was discovered in the state of Texas, there were plantations in the state of Texas where black people were still on those plantations, completely oblivious to the fact that they've been liberated. That was because the message did not reach them that they were freed. That is a similar situation, an analogous situation to what's going on in the light of GAGUT, in terms of GAGUT has already freed black people into the ultimate position of being the most intelligent, richest, and most powerful race. But black people are not aware of that. Jim Crow is aware of it, as you can see from the Gauss year 2005 celebration, from Dasgupta's declaring Professor Yiborn as being closer to God than any of us, and this Yale study in front of you, which has ascertained in the labs using Eta sub n that the black people have an Eta sub intelligence, Eta intelligence of Eta sub 28 plus compared to non-blacks who have an Eta sub 19 minus intelligence. So now the order has been that we indoctrinate ourselves on the truth of GAGUT so we can understand who we're supposed to be instead of the state of acting, which many of our people have gotten too comfortable with because of the last 2,500 years of fraud and falsehoods from Jim Crow on our people. That's the importance that I want to share with you all today and get you to understand, so that when you go into this briefing, it's important that you understand that you may have said, oh, well, you heard the brother go over this before. You may have heard me say it in the other broadcast that you were part of. But why I go over this again and again is so you can understand how GAGUT has now freed the black people into a position not of just global leadership, but in being the ultimate in terms of intelligence, in terms of rich, and in terms of undefeatable or powerful race. Now, I also want to take some time to share with you some other things pertaining to what we were talking about the other day about the GAGUT singular element discovery and the Afro-Persian part. There's a piece here which I'd like to share with you, which is the GAGUT infallibility verified by Russian and American scientists. Do you all see that in front of you?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. This is a press release that was written back in April 22nd, 2010 from our university. GAGUT's infallibility further verified by Russian and American scientists. God Almighty's Grand Unified Theorem, GAGUT, G-I-J, comma, J=0, as an infallible revelation from God, has been experimentally verified again by Russian and American scientists. The experiment was done as a joint collaboration between Russian scientists at the Joint Institute for Nuclear Research in Dubna, Russia, and American scientists at the Lawrence Livermore Laboratory in Livermore, California. There's a link there to that as well. The experiment clearly verified the GAGUT singular element discovery, also known as GSED, G-S-E-D, GAGUT singular element discovery, through which God revealed through Professor Oyibo that the periodic table has Afro-Trojan, which is known as Africa the origin, formerly called hydrogen or hide the origin, as the only element, and the rest of the so-called 117 quote-unquote elements on the periodic table are nothing more but nuclear compounds of such a said Afro-Trojan. God revealed the secret of the black magic to Professor Oyibo, as can be seen in the following videos. Now, first, I want you to show your videos. I hope you're both watching, because this is important. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, here's the video.
It's documented. When you're speaking about it,
you can all hear and see it.
Yep.
It's something that your mind is normally open for. When the education, the word education.
Back to News 12 Long Island, we're going to salute a very talented Long Islander right now, Dr. Gabriel Oyibo of Dix Hills, revising Einstein's famous theory of relativity, and his new calculations has earned him a Nobel Prize nomination for physics this year. We are very pleased to have Dr. Oyibo with us. Thanks for coming in.
Him a Nobel Prize nomination. Gabriel Oyibo created the unified field theory. It's an education based in quantum physics. The theory combines the works of both Einstein and Newton. Unified field theory blends math and science to give insight into the very basis of our existence.
It turned out that people found mathematics to be worn around. As you know, mathematics is a language.
Dr. Gabriel Oyibo has answers to the questions that puzzled Einstein right up until his death. He's unified the theories of electromagnetic force and gravity, incorporating quantum physics. But if you look beyond first glance, you see Dr. Oyibo's breakthrough is far more than numbers and equations.
Because the answer to the question, is it the Big Bang theory that the universe came into existence, or the word of God, you know, which the scripture says created the universe. And so Albert Einstein was preoccupied with how to find that solution. And he died in the process trying to find a solution. And so therefore people recognize that that must be an interesting problem. So everybody jumped on the bandwagon trying to find a solution. And what has happened is that we were able to be blessed by the Almighty God with a solution to that problem. After studying his work for 35 years, you know, basically what we found was that the account given by the science, which is a Big Bang theory, I have a common denominator in a wave theory.
a wave theory.
Yes, because the Big Bang has a wave connotation to it in terms of the sound and the explosion. And then the Word of God is also a wave because that's mm-hmm. a sound wave. Mm-hmm. So basically the scriptures and science are speaking the same language.
Hmm. Interesting.
Yes.
So the theory of relativity, of course, just explain that.
Yeah, the theory of relativity, you know, was on its way to answering the total question, and it dealt with the gravity, which is a major part of those this force field. There are four of them that are known currently: gravity, electromagnetic, strong, and the weak forces. Okay. The theory of relativity actually deals with the gravity component. Maxwell had dealt with the electromagnetic. The strong and the weak is being puzzling everybody. So they want all those four combined. And what the equation did was to combine not just those four, but others that may not have been found yet. The graph that you're seeing there is the unification of the four force fields that are known, as well as those that have not been known yet.
Now, the next thing I'm going to be showing you all is a video that shows the Afro-Trojan, or Africa the origin, is the correct true element. Just a second. There it is. Let me show you that video. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Called the micro heaven, which was the womb, and there was a macro heaven that was the universe. Why would they associate?
And in order to see this mystery
with the universe,
I would take you back to the periodic chart in your chemistry. Periodic chart has atom, hydrogen atom as number one. That is again, proton, positive charge, and neutron, which is no charge, and electron, which is negative charge. And what GAGUT has done is put up a model that would explain this mystery. And in the process, revise the entire chemistry, as you're going to see shortly. Okay? What happens is, this is number one. Number two, of course, is a bigger atom, okay, which has, okay, that's helium. Helium has two protons, helium, He. Okay, this is the second atom on the periodic chart. And this, they have two protons and two electrons. GAGUT has, in developing a model to explain the mystery, has observed that this could be broken down into two units. Okay? Two units. Helium. The top one is a proton, neutron, and an electron, which looks like hydrogen, so you might as well consider it hydrogen, isn't it? And the bottom one is also proton, neutron, electron, which also looks like another hydrogen atom. So helium would then be equal to two hydrogen units.
How is now written?
It's He. It's written He, okay? He helium. That's correct. So this is number two on the periodic chart, okay? And you're gonna look at the lithium, okay? Okay, again, three protons. And three neutrons and three electrons. Again, GAGUT looks at this and says, okay, you can look at this and look at that. Okay? And observe again that lithium, Li, is indeed, this is one hydrogen. okay? Another hydrogen and another hydrogen. So there's three hydrogen units. Okay? Well, if you proceed further, you will find out that the following is true. Carbon, which has six, you know, would be equivalent of six hydrogen units. It's number six on the periodic chart. It will be six hydrogen units. Oxygen, which is number eight, would also be eight hydrogen units. Okay? You're going to go some scrap, you know, would have.
Is everyone watching?
59 hydrogen units. Whatever the number
59 is. Is everyone watching?
Right? On the period yes. And then you keep on going, and gold, okay, would be 79 hydrogen units. Okay? So this scrap metal going into gold, according to GAGUT explanation, is like starting from here, which will be the scrap metal, okay? Scrap has 59 hydrogen units. When you add 20 more hydrogen units to that, right? That means you're pumping 20 hydrogen units into the scrap metal. The scrap metal is here. What you get is a 79 hydrogen. 20 plus 59 is 79. This, therefore, is the model of the mystery. Okay? This mystery here. And of course, this here.
Okay. So that's what I wanted to share with you about this. Now, keep in mind, going back to what I was reading to before, in the videos above, Professor Oyibo was ordered by God to decode and reveal the secret of the black language, a feat which Sir Professor Isaac Newton and other scientific legends unsuccessfully tried to accomplish. That's what they call black magic. People like Sir Professor Isaac Newton sought to try to understand it, but failed. Professor Joe Yibo explained the black magic as used by the ancient Africans to turn scrap metal into gold as a fusing of two atoms, each with their own number of Afrocrogian units, to get a third one with its own number of Afrocrogian units. Professor Joe Yibo specifically proved that one can produce gold known by its symbol AU, which is 79 Afrocrogian units, by fusing praseodymium, PR, which is what it's known by, which is 59 Afrocrogian units, to calcium, Ca, 20 Afrocrogian units. Or that PR, 59 Afrocrogian units, plus Ca, which is 20 Afrocrogian units, equals AU, 79 Afrocrogian units. This is the GAGUT formula that was copied and used by the Russian and American scientists to produce GAGUTium-117. These scientists basically fused calcium, Ca, which is 20 Afrocrogian units, to berkelium. Now, berkelium is BK, a different Afrocrogian compound, or a nuclear compound, which is 97 Afrocrogian units, to produce the so-called new element, quote-unquote, GAGUTium-117, which is 117 Afrocrogian units, or that BK, which is 97 Afrocrogian units, plus Ca, which is Afrocrogian units, equals GAGUTium-117, which is 117 Afrocrogian units. The experiment was precisely done and prescribed by Professor G. Oyibo through the videos that you just saw. Did you understand that?
Yes. Yep.
Are you sure?
Yes.
It was Ogaro?
All hydrogen.
Praise God for that. But this is critical because people like Alan Shabazz and Brother Dave, who you said, they wanted to know about the gold. GAGUT Has infallibly proved how you get gold out of GAGUT, has it not?
Yes.
Praise God for them. That's the basis of the treaty between the non-blacks and the black people. Because now, as GAGUT has proven through Professor Oyibo being blessed of Eta sub-infinity intelligence, we are now kings and queens of intelligence.
Praise God.
This is why black people now are to be the only leaders anywhere around the world, which is what happened to Obama, or God bless you, in terms of Obama's election in 2008 and 2012. But unfortunately, because black people did not digest this point, something which Jim Crow did digest, the 2016 election was compromised due to that lack of understanding. Can you see from the formula that was just presented to you why Professor Oyibo, as a single human being, is the richest human being ever?
Yep.
Mr. Cruz, I didn't hear you. What was that?
Yes.
Station.
Yes.
Scratch.
By extension, because Professor Oyibo is the richest person ever, richest creature ever, black people who share Professor G. Oyibo's genes are now the richest race because of this. You all see that?
Yes.
So when you've been ordered to come to the briefing and you're saying you're poor, you are directly contradicting the God order that you're seeing in front of you. Can you see that?
Yes.
Yep.
I didn't hear you. I need to hear a more confident answer.
Yes.
You have to understand, since God has blessed Professor Oyibo with the formula to create gold, that makes him the richest person ever created. We as black people share the same genes as Professor G. Oyibo. That means black people are the richest race. Now, in light of that, with the God order you're seeing in front of you, black people have no business crying or claiming that they're poor. The only reason you do that is when you don't understand what GAGUT is, or as the late Adam Clayton Powell Jr. once said, what's in your hands? GAGUT is in your hands. Do you understand me?
Yes.
Yep.
Can you also see through the same experiment that OFAPIT Institute of Technology doesn't need anyone's money? Can you see that?
Yeah.
Yes.
If you give money, it is only being done to show and send a message to Jim Crow of your own awareness of GAGUT. As I've reiterated to you several times when we've talked in the past, we're not asking for money because we need it. We're not even asking you, period. We have gold, the formula to produce gold. The reason why the donations and the registrations are critical are for you to send a message to Jim Crow that you are aware of GAGUT and you know what's in your hands.
Praise God.
And that you are the richest race. That is the message you are sending Jim Crow when you are making a donation or registering to come into the briefing. That's the only reason we're doing that. Or we're telling you to do that. It's so that you can send a message to Jim Crow. You are the richest race. Do you understand that?
Yes, that's what we want to do.
Yeah.
Well, that's what you need to get to other brothers. The other brothers like Jonathan and the others you were talking about, they need to understand that point. Because not understanding that, and a lot of times black people unfortunately have a parochial mentality because of the mind state that has been programmed by Jim Crow. They don't see the reality of the situation. They see it as the way Jim Crow has taught them to think. Jim Crow has taught you your so-called three-fifths human being. GAGUT has decoded in reality your five-thirds. You're five-thirds of human being, which makes you superhumans. Jim Crow declared your so-called the least intelligent race. GAGUT has now proven and forced Jim Crow to even recognize, as they did through Gottigan, through the Yale study and through Dasgupta, that you are the most intelligent race, when they have officially declared Professor Oyibo as being closer to God than any of us. Do you understand that?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, and that's basically what this has shown to you. The research that was done here that proves that the God order has given us the formula to produce gold from scrap metal. That means we are the richest race. We don't need anyone's money. That's the important thing that has to be digested with our people right now. Do you understand that?
Yes. Yep.
God has ordained the new so-called element of GAGUT in 117 that to illustrate that the educational curricula globally needs to be revised to also teach GAGUT, and that Professor Oyibo is the greatest genius ever created, since GAGUT has proven to be an infallible revelation from God. Do you all understand that?
Yes.
I didn't hear you, Mr. Cruz.
I do understand.
So
now that you understand this, the next step is now making sure your fellow brothers and sisters come into this briefing so they can understand the infallible revelation of GAGUT.
Yeah, they certainly will.
They can't
will.
Be running away from where Jim Crow has surrendered to GAGUT. Black people for whom GAGUT won the war should not be running away or trying to hide or cower from GAGUT at this point.
Right.
This is the basis also of the Afro-Trojan bomb. You have the ability to create any element from scrap. That's what they did in the experiment when they took berkelium and... Let me get up the news article on the 117 element, which they call super heavy element, so you all can see it. Just one second. Please bear in mind. Just one second. Okay, you see the page in front of you. Hello?
I see it.
Okay, do you see the spike at the top?
Whoa. So that's the one from that's the one that was used by combining 117 Afro-Trojan elements. I mean atoms.
Yes. It's important that you understand it, because Professor Oyibo has the formula to produce gold. Professor Oyibo doesn't need anyone's money. Professor Oyibo is the richest human being. But when you hear brothers acting like, oh, they, when you tell them, or sisters even, when you're telling them that they've been ordered to register to come to the briefing, they see it as, oh, Jim Crow's, oh, that you're just giving the money over to Professor Oyibo. Oh, that it's just some sort of scheme just to make money. The thing that has to be understood is Professor Oyibo has the entirety of all wealth, because there's the formula that can turn scrap metal to gold. That they it's have been gold. Ordered to come to the briefing as a means of showing the message to Jim Crow they are aware of GAGUT. Like the Jewish people showed their understanding of relativity through donations, Black people have to do the same in terms of showing their understanding of GAGUT. That's the only way that Jim Crow is going to respect Black people, which right now they are not, because they're not seeing Black people showing their understanding of GAGUT. Do you understand that point, Mr. Cruz?
Yes, I do.
Can you go over what I just said? I want you to repeat to me back what I said so I can understand if you understand it.
Well, first and foremost, the first point that is very clear to me is that Mr. Oyibo is
Professor
Oyibo is the richest man on earth and in the universe. He doesn't need any money, and that the important thing is to show Jim Crow that we stand behind GAGUT, and we're showing him that we acknowledge GAGUT as the infinite source of all knowledge. So, I mean, That's all that I can pretty much wrap around my head right now. Not a whole lot. I just...
But you got the essence of it. The part that you need to add to that is when you see brothers and sisters, when they're told that they've been ordered to register for the briefing, and you see them saying, oh, this must be just some trying to get rich scheme for Professor Oyibo. Professor Oyibo has all the wealth. Professor Oyibo is blessed with the formula that can turn scrap metal to gold. We do not need anyone's money here. The reason why they've been ordered to come to the briefing is to show Jim Crow through PayPal, which is our CNN, in effect, that Black people are aware of GAGUT. Right now, black people are not doing that, and that's what's leading to the problems that we're suffering from as a people. Black people showing their understanding of GAGUT through the donations on PayPal will show Jim Crow that the black people own America. Do you understand that, both of you?
Yes, I do.
Mr. Uzogara? Mr. Uzogara?
You already know that. You already know that.
But I want to see if you understand it, sir.
I understand.
Praise God. That's what we want to get across to you all today. If you own America, you can't be poor. Do you understand that point? Do you understand that?
I'm sorry. Yes, I do.
Yes.
I know you're talking to me. Yes, I do.
If you own America, you can't be poor.
So we need to deal with the people like Jonathan and brother Alan Shabazz and all these others who are too not understanding of this God order. They're too shy and too timid to come and show the understanding of the God order, which is the ultimate hip. I mean, GAGUT is supposed to make you the most intelligent, richest, and most powerful race. There's no business of being shy or timid in light of such a God order. So what are your suggestions in terms of dealing with that? How to talk with them? How to talk to people like Jonathan and Shabazz and so forth?
You know, the solution to the problem is to continue to reach out to them, you know, on weekends when they, you know, for example, the female Brittany, she says that she's available on Sundays. So I'm going to continue to call her on Sundays on that given day when she's not doing a lot around the house because she has a child to take care of. As far as Jonathan, I see him not all the time, but I see him from time to time. What I can do is continue to call him and see how we can get him to join or donate to the next briefing and keep it going, because I do know one thing. I do know one thing. I'm getting closer and closer to receiving the funds that I'm going to receive. And I'm not giving because I'm giving it because I feel as if though I can contribute to something that is helping the black race. For the longest time, I've been battling and trying to indoctrinate people with different philosophies and things of this nature, and it has led me to nothing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give funds so that we can have a store here in West Palm Beach and people can come see for themselves. And I plan on putting the store next to the library. So, you know, I plan on doing big things with the institution of GAGUT. And so, like I said, I'm just waiting my timing. I certainly don't feel that Professor Gabriel Oyibo needs any of our funds. But if we want to give it out of our hearts, then we can do so. And that's what I plan to do. For the record, and let the record reflect.
No. That's a good point, but like I said, we got to get our people to understand this point. This is the real problem that we're having as a people in terms of not understanding what we've been blessed with. That's what, and this is the thing that you're seeing, do you see the article in front of you?
Yes.
Scientists discover new super heavy element 117. That's GAGUTium 117. And you can see that. Yes, the important thing to understand in light of that is that this is the GAGUTium 117 element. But don't call it that because of the attempt to try to hide the blessing that we've had as a people through GAGUT. So when you see this, that you can see the date is April 13th, 2010. You see that. Does everyone see that?
Yeah.
Okay. So what's important to understand is that it says here, posters of the periodic table on the walls of science schools in, labs and schools around the world will need to be updated after the discovery of the new super heavy element, element 117, which is GAGUTium 117. With the temporary name of unseptium, the temporary symbol UUS, and that's not really important. The important thing is to understand. The real name is GAGUTium 117. It is the only missing element in row 7 of the periodic table until its discovery by an international team of scientists from Russia and US. That is part of the fraud. It needs to be digested. When you see that, when we had the document, the press release, which illustrated the nature of the GAGUT experiment, the GAGUT single element discovery element, that discovery was conducted back in 2002, which showed scrap metal, turn scrap metal to gold. Let me play that back to you so you can all see it again. Are y'all ready?
Yes.
Yep.
Let's prove that statement. Okay, here it is. Just one second. Okay, does everyone see it's in front of them now?
Yes.
Let me play the video again so you can see it.
Known as microcosm and macrocosm. There was a heaven called.
Can you all see it?
Heaven, which was the womb.
And can you see it?
Macro heaven, that was the universe. Why would they associate?
In order to see this mystery, I would take you back to the periodic chart in your chemistry.
Can you all see what's on the screen
the
right now?
Chart has a
yes.
Atom.
Yeah.
That is hydrogen atom at number one. That is, again, proton, positive charge, and neutron, which is no charge, and electron, which is negative charge. And what GAGUT has done is put up a model that would explain this mystery. And in the process, revised the entire chemistry, as you're going to see shortly. Okay? What happens is, this is number one. Number two, of course, is a bigger atom, okay, which has, okay, that's helium. Helium has two protons, helium, He. Okay, this is the second atom, A, on the periodic chart. And this, they have two neutrons and two electrons. GAGUT has, in developing a model to explain the mystery, has looked, observed that this could be broken down into two units. Okay? Two units. Helium. The top one is a proton, neutron, and an electron, which looks like hydrogen, so you might as well consider it hydrogen, isn't it? And the bottom one is also proton, neutron, electron, which also looks like another hydrogen atom. So helium would then be equal to two hydrogen units. It's He, He. Written He, okay? H helium. That's correct. So this is number two on the periodic chart, okay? And you're gonna look at the lithium, okay? Okay, again, three protons and three neutrons, and three electrons. Again, GAGUT looks at this and says, okay, you can look at this, and look at that, okay? And observe again that lithium, Li, is indeed, this is one electron, I'm sorry, one hydrogen, okay, another hydrogen, and another hydrogen. So there's three hydrogen units. Okay? if you proceed further, you will find out that the following is true. Carbon, which has six, you know, would be equivalent of six hydrogen units. It's number six on the periodic chart. It will be six hydrogen units. Oxygen, which is number eight, would also be eight hydrogen units. Okay? You're gonna go some scrap, you know, would have equivalent of say 59 hydrogen units, whatever the number 59 is, okay, on the periodic chart. And then you keep on going, and gold, okay, would be 79 hydrogen units, okay? So this scrap metal going into gold, according to GAGUT explanation, it's like starting from here, which will be the scrap metal, okay? Scrap has 59 hydrogen units. When you add 20 more hydrogen units to that, okay? That means you're pumping 20 hydrogen units into the scrap metal. The scrap metals here, what you get is a 79 hydrogen. 20 plus 59 is 79. This, therefore, is the model of the mystery. Okay? This mystery here. And of course, this here. This the transformation that's going on here. That's GAGUT's explanation. Okay? So what that says is technically you could turn anything into gold. Of course, the modern day process used to do something called transmutations of metal. Okay? And they you know, I don't believe they've perfected it to the point where they can turn anything to gold yet. But they would take metals usually and so on. But on this basic principle, they turn it into gold and turn it from one form to the other, which is a basic transformation, which seems to be also consistent with the GAGUT theorem, proof base, okay? Since, you know, from the word of God transforming and all that, you know, so transformation is a way of life, in other words. But the other thing, as I mentioned, is a revision of chemistry altogether. Because now, rather than been looking at this table units called elements, okay, as, you know, some kind of a convoluted kind of description, you can simply look at them as a group of a set of groups of hydrogen units that are stable. That's what elements will be classified as. And that's much, much easier to visualize and work with. Now, that means that the entire chemistry will have to be revised. And things that have been studied and investigated before could be now looked at with this model. Okay? And, you know, quite a few things could be come out as a surprise. But in addition, of course, the origin of the mystery is explained by this. This, in effect, is what you call transmutation, in effect. But this obviously have a more sophisticated way of pumping this extra hydrogen units into the scrap in order to get the gold out of it. Okay? Which also now, you know, presents itself for investigation. Okay? So that is with chemistry, but we're not done yet. Therefore, all elements are unified.
Hello? Yeah, I'm here. I'm still here. I'm listening. Is it just us two?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, yeah, brother. I intend to do a lot of things for GAGUT, man, because it showed me that even though you don't understand God completely, God is still gonna find someone to bring us a message that is gonna transcend any type of insecurity. You know what I'm saying? Insecurity about ourselves, and GAGUT has done that. So I praise God for allowing me to be one of the chosen ones to contribute at this time and age. Because, you know, if we really had the support from the black people, we would see signals, you know, in mainstream media. But we don't see that. Do you follow what I'm saying, brother?
You have no idea.
You know, for example, there's this one lady called Miss Blue. You know who that is in the conscious community?
Yeah.
Like, I never seen her present Professor Gabriel Oyibo. I never seen it. I'm waiting for that day to happen. I haven't seen Phil Valentine. Well, I've seen Phil Valentine one time. So, yeah, he did his job. But there's a numerous amount of people that are in power. People like Nazir Ra, Memnon Uzan, Dr. El Hendu. You know, just big-time people that could push this thing even further. But, you know, despite all of that, I don't lose the goal. The goal is to get common people, you know, average people to start contributing too, because that's what's important. And
preach it out.
Yeah. So what's going on? Where's Mr. Glover?
I don't know. Hold on one second.
You hear me?
Yes.
All right. What you just saw.
Hello?
I understand. Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
What I'm saying is, do you see, from 2002 was when that video was published, which GAGUT presented the actual formula of how to turn scrap metal to gold. It turns Burkele how to now. They did everything that was an experiment, but replaced the praseodymium with berkelium. Can you see that? Can you see that?
Yes.
20 Afrocrogen units plus 59 Afrocrogen units produced 79 Afrocrogen units. That was what you saw in the actual document. It's right in front of you. Can you read the paragraph that's in front of you?
Yes.
Can you read it out loud?
It says, in the videos above, Professor Gabriel Oyibo was considered by God to decode and reveal the secret of the black magic, a feature which Sir Isaac Newton and other scientific legends unsuccessfully tried in accomplishing. Professor Gabriel Oyibo explained the black magic as used by ancient Africans to learn scrap metal into gold as a fusing of two atoms, else which is own number of Afrocrogen units, to get a third one with its own author of Afrocrogen units. Professor Gabriel Oyibo specifically proved that one can produce gold, and 79 Afrikogen units by fusing
Prodesium.
I could barely see the letters, so I'm just bear with me. Afrikogen units. This is the GAGUT formula that was copied and used by the Russian and American scientists to produce GAGUT.
Read that GAGUT. Last sentence again.
This is the GAGUT formula that was copied and used by the Russian and American scientists to produce GAGUTium 117. Is that correct? Did I pronounce it correct?
That's correct.
These scientists basically fuse calcium, Ca20 Afrikogen units to berkelium, BK97 Afrikogen units to produce the new so-called element, GAGUTium 117. 117 Afrikogen units, or that BK97 Afrikogen units plus Ca20 Afrikogen units greater than GAGUTium.
No, you can say it goes to or equals to GAGUTium. You just see that from the numbers. Like we did in our experiment back in 2002. Prodesium, which is 59, plus Ca, which is 20, equals Au, which is 79. Just as if you had here berkelium, which is 97, instead of the prodesium, you replace with berkelium. You still have the same calcium, which is 20. You get GAGUTium. That's taking the same blueprint that Mr. Cruz. Hello, Mr. Uzogara.
Can you hear me?
Hello?
Yes, can you hear me?
What was the last thing you heard me say?
Mr. Cruz.
What did I say before that in terms of, do you see from the experiment that was right in front of you, how Jim yes. Crow has in effect, first of all, do you see it up on your screen right now?
Yes.
Can you read that last two sentences that you read?
Let me see. All I see is all for appetite, the capital letters. I can't really see anything else.
1 second. Torture was in 2002. Just 1 second, please. I'm trying to work on the screen share.